And the toddler killed after he ran into the street last week has not been laid to rest yet.
Now, the boy's family is waiting on his father to get here in the country. KTV News Watch 7's Michelle Bandor talked with the aunt of 2-year-old Maximiliano Delgado-Morales. She's live in the Newsplex. Michelle.
Adrian, Max's father is in El Salvador and had an immigration hearing just this morning. The boy's aunt tells me that he's been waiting for a year to become a U.S. citizen. Regardless, the family hopes he can get back to Omaha soon to say goodbye to his son one last time.
A long cross with flowers marks the spot where little Max Delgado died. His mother, with her infant son in her arms, watched as a truck hit her 2-year-old.
He just got away from her, and right when she just didn't have any time to get him. It was just an accident, because the daycare is on a busy street.
Amanda Huffman is Max's aunt. She says the family is surrounding and comforting Max's mother, Felix Delgado, as she grieves without her husband.
It's too hard for her. She still doesn't talk to people about it. She won't talk about that day. It's just too hard for her.
She's waiting for her husband to return to the U.S. to help bury their son. Omar Delgado took this picture of Max about a year ago. That was the last time he held his little boy.
We're waiting for him. It's really important that he's here for that day.
The family has accepted Max's death as a horrible accident. The 81-year-old driver didn't see the boy run into the street. Police say he didn't do anything wrong.
The family doesn't have any anger or anything towards the driver. They know it was an accident. It's nobody's fault. It just happened, and nobody can explain why.
They don't dwell on the why or the how. They just remember a happy little boy and help his mother hold on to his memory, even if Max was only with her a short time.
He was a really good kid.
The family has set up a memorial fund at SAC Credit Union. It's under Max's father's name, Elias Omar Delgado. His aunt tells me that they've already received donations and are so grateful for any help they get. She also tells me they're sending out a big thank you to the woman who stopped to help perform CPR on Max. Reporting live in the Newsplex, Michelle Bandor, KETV, Newswatch 7.